Today we're going to transform our sunset shots into something more cinematic like this right here. A deep blue look, very saturated, much of details into it. So let's get started and see how we can recreate this inside Adobe Premiere Pro. What up guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome again to a very exciting Premiere Pro tutorial. Today we're going to color grade again inside Premiere because we are going to create this very deep blue, very rich contrast shot of a sunset. Now before I'm going to start, I first have to mention something very exciting, and that is that our sponsor Rocket Stock is giving away 16 free light and dust overlay effects. So definitely make sure to visit the first link in the description below to download this, and these are actually just light and dust effects which you can blend in inside Adobe Premiere Pro to create unique looks, and definitely make sure to check out this promo video so that you can get some ideas on how to use this. I also have these loaded in right here in my Premiere project. You can find some nice things in here like this beam light from the top and some other things here like this beams here from the side, etc. You can kind of blend these with your clips and create unique looks. So make sure to definitely visit that first link. All right, I've got a blank sequence right here with that shot in it. It is shot in V-Lock on my Panasonic GH5, which gives that very flat look, but that way it captures more detail. I have more dynamic range, which means more detail in the shadows and more detail in the highlights. And that is exactly how you want to start when you are going to shoot a sunset. And once you have that very flat shot, you can take it into Premiere Pro to create that unique look that we're going to create right now. So we're going to do everything with the Lumetri panel, and if you can't locate that, you can head over to the window here on top and select Lumetri color right here. And that will open up this window here on the right side. Now since this was shot in V-Lock, I'm going to apply a LUT to it that will transform this shot into a Rec 709, and I've already loaded it in right here. Now if you're shooting in C-Lock or an S-Lock, there will also exist a LUT for that. Just search on the internet and just type in your kind of lock naming, for example, V-Lock to Rec 709, and then you will find a LUT for that on the internet. You can just load that in right here in Lumetri. And right away you can see that we have a much better contrast here. It's still pretty dull, so we're going to tweak this a bit more on the right side. First of all, I'm going to decrease the exposure. It is shot a little bit too bright, but that's okay. I'm going to decrease that a tiny bit like this. We want to keep it a little bit dark and definitely preserve those highlights. That is something that we're going to work on as well here. With the highlight slider, I'm going to pull this down, and that will definitely preserve those details in these highlights that we want. Now be careful though, if you're going to decrease this too much, you will see kind of this gray tone coming in here, and that is because we have actually got an overexposed part and we can't recover anything from that. So if you're going to decrease those highlights too much, it will just start to look gray. But that's not a big problem. We're going to recover those gray areas later on. The next thing I want to do here is actually increase the shadows. And that will introduce some more detail in those shadows here in these waves right here. Now, as we're doing this, we are actually, again, lowering that contrast, making the image look flat. So we're going to add back contrast in it, but in a different way. We're actually going to do that by decreasing that blacks. And at this point, you really want to look at your image that you're not pulling these blacks too much down. Of course, there are things like this birch right here. It's going to be a silhouette. I mean, we can't go beyond that. There's no fill height here from the front. But just make sure that the parts where you have detail, like this wave here in the back, that you're not going to crush that old way like so. Something like this looks good. All right, the next thing I want to do here is increase the whites. And with this, we are actually going to recover those gray areas. So definitely look here at that sunlight on top. It is a little bit gray, so I'm going to increase the whites a tiny bit to give that some more pop. You know, it is overexposed, so we can't do much about that. So don't worry too much if you're going to overexpose it a little bit more by doing this. Important is that you're going to keep detail around that overexposed part. All right, we've got a basic contrast set right now. The next thing is just adding a little bit of saturation to add some colors into here, which is really going to do that magic, as you can see. And once done that, we are done with the basic corrections, and we can actually head over into the creative tab. And what I often do is just add a little bit of sharpness, and that is because I have set my sharpness off in my camera. And for those who are thinking, yes, you should do this with the unsharpened mask, but you know, for very wide shots, it is okay to add a little bit of sharpness through here. After that, I'm going to increase the vibrance, and what that will do is really tackle those blue areas more. All right, the next step is going to be the curves, and from here, I'm only going to work on the hue saturation curves. And I'm going to select the two colors that are visible in the shot, and that are the more orange colors here, the warm tones and the blue tones. So let's start with that one on top. I'm going to select that by just setting 2 points first to make a selection of that color right here and here. And now I've got this part right here selected. And I can actually just pull that a little bit up, adding more saturation to those warm tones, as you can see. And that really makes that sky pop out, or that sun actually in this case. And then also for the sea, I'm going to select more of that deep blue color here and increase that saturation as well. And that way we are creating more color contrast. And we are actually now done with the basic color corrections of this shot. The next thing that we are going to do is work separately on the sky and the waves and the beach right here. So I'm going to hold down my Alt key on my keyboard and drag this clip to channel number 2 to make a duplication of this. And some of you have asked before, why am I doing this? I can also just make a mask inside my Lumetri effect, but it's just something that I personally find more convenient to work on multiple layers. So let me show you what I'm meaning here. I'm going to head over to the effects controls on top, and from my opacity here, by the way, make sure that you have that second layer selected here on top. And with that opacity here selected, I'm going to create a mask with my pen tool. But first, I'm going to zoom out a bit more in my program monitor here. I'm gonna set that to 25%. Take that pen tool and just kind of draw a mask over that horizon like this. And then just increase that feather here. You can see that feather area with these dotted lines. And now if I'm going to disable the first layer, you're gonna see that we have that sky separate now. All right, for that sky, let me just set that back to fit. What I'm gonna do is with that layer selected on top, inside my Lumetri color, I'm going to do some adjustments here. That's going to be specifically done for that sky. And I wanna make sure that that sky is a little bit more bluer. So I'm going to decrease that temperature. And you can see here what it kinda does. That sky is really getting that deep blue look. And we can make that even more deeper by decreasing that highlight even more. And we are really going to crush that here, as you can see, make that very dark and increase that whites even more just to make sure that the sun is not going to look gray. It is overexposed, so we can't do much about that. And just look how this is popping out now. Pay attention here, guys. I have not touched the contrast slider. I am setting my own contrast here with playing around with the highlights, shadows, whites, and the blacks. And that is the power to making such color gradings. All right, and now we can add some different colors to the bottom, which are the waves and the beach. And I'm going to make this a little bit more warmer so that the sun is actually reflecting more here on the bottom. And perhaps you also want to add a little bit of magenta to it, which sits kind of more in that bluish tone. And finally, what I'll do is just add a general contrast. And this is the first time that I'm using this slider right here, and that will really give some more punch to that bottom area right here. And let's look at the results right now. It looks pretty awesome. Very nice, deep blue, rich contrast sunset. This was, by the way, shot in Normandy in France, where I'm currently at on vacation. It is really beautiful here, guys. And I have tons of more sunset shots right here, which I'm probably going to color grade something similar. All right, guys, that was it for this video. Thank you so much for watching again. Make sure to subscribe to see us every Tuesday and Friday for a new tutorial video. If you like, you can download this project file as well so that you can practice on the same clip that I was working on from the description below, or you can also just hit this button right here. Thank you again for watching, and stay creative.